Hi, my name is Hannah, and I'm also a senior. Most relationships fail because we spend too much time pointing out each other's mistakes and not enough time enjoying each other's company. Losing friends is never easy, and most of the time it's over stupid things. I don't really have anything significant to say other than last year I made a big mistake. I let petty things ruin friendships with great people. Even though there was a part of me that wanted to mend those relationships, I let pride get in the way. Because if I'm not good enough for them, why should they be good enough for me? Instead of sitting down and trying to talk it out with them, we decided to do all the communication over texting, which was mistake number one. My next mistake was letting my pride get in the way and letting something that would have been a small fight get turned into the end of a friendship and such a dislike for each other that it felt almost impossible to be in the same room. So even though there came a point where we all wanted to fix the relationship, none of us wanted to be the first to say so, and we decided to wait until fate walked, our second quarter of our senior year to finally sit down. Proverbs 11 says, when pride comes, then comes disgrace, but with humility comes wisdom. The faithful retreat was a perfect setting for forgiveness and mending. Instead of focusing on the mistakes, we were finally able to focus on enjoying each other's company again. So although the story had a happy ending of friends reconnecting, there was a year lost simply because we did not want to talk. During junior year, it didn't seem like a big deal because I was so hurt by what had happened that I didn't take the time to think about how they were feeling. But by the time senior year started, I realized that this was my last chance, and my last year to leave an impact on my classmates. It wasn't and isn't my mission to make sure everyone in my class likes me, but I do not want to leave with regrets and things left unsaid. The thing I hate most about how I handled the situation was that I waited so long to try and fix it. I was asked to talk about mending relationships, and I hope that by giving a little background on my experiences in doing so, it was able to give those who need it a little guidance on how to handle it. Basically, the gist of this was to show people that in high school, we are so often told by older people that the problems we deal with are petty. At the time, it seems life-ending, but I can assure you that although it may be hurtful, it isn't worth holding on to. Maybe not for the other person, but for yourself. Luke 6:37 says, do not judge, and you will not be judged. Do not condemn, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. You know, I totally understand the frustration of having someone do the same thing over and over again and feeling like they just don't care. But take a look at your own life and see how you have hurt people and, more importantly, how you have hurt God. We spend our entire life hurting Him and going against Him day after day, and then we hold on to the one thing that one person said that one time. As Christians, we are taught to strive to be like Christ, and Christ loved everyone and He forgives everyone over and over again. Forgiving doesn't always mean forgetting and being best friends again. The definition of forgive is to give up your resentment. So take time to think not only about the people you need to forgive, but also the people you need forgiveness from.